God, for once again the opportunity to share God's word. Today I'm going to share with you living a life of love. Alright, I'm sharing living a life of love. Alright, in the book of Daniel. Alright, Daniel chapter 9 talks about his prayer. Okay, his prayer during the first year of Darius, son of Zaxi, made ruler over the Babylonian kingdom. Alright, his prayer was that their forefathers, and they have sinned against God. And because of their sin, they are in this exile, and in this enemy territory. And he asked God for forgiveness. And he thanked God for the covenant of love, and for the ancestor, as well as themselves. But yet, this covenant was not observed by the kings, observed by the ancestor and the people of the Jews. All right, he asked for forgiveness for all of them, and then we know that in his humility, and God sent angel Gabriel to reveal to him the visions of the end times. All right, about the 70 weeks. All right. So I think he is a very good example of a very humble servant. A man is a high-class slave and a powerful man in the Babylonian kingdom, and yet so humble. And he's really a classic example, and a good example for us to follow and observe. And to model after his his life. It's an interesting book, in the interesting chapter. Now let's look at the Daniel chapter 9, verse 1. In the first years of Darius, son of Zaxi, as I pronounced that, was who was made ruler over the Babylonian kingdom. And someone was suggested it's probably around 539 and 538 BC. And this time, but we know that Cyrus come into the power, okay, in 539 BC, and he defeated this Babylon and Ashuri, okay, the golden rule, all right, and Daniel also in the way that they still keep him and because he trustworthy. And in the first year of his reign of this king, but this is Darius, the son, alright, the Medes, and Medes by descent. I, Daniel, understood from the scripture according to the word of the Lord given to Jeremiah the prophet that the desolations of Jerusalem will last 70 years. We know of the sin historically, and because of the sin of the forefather, King Solomon, and the subsequent kings, idolatry, and disobeying the commandment of God, and then there came the destruction of the desolation of Jerusalem. That means the temple was destroyed, the Solomon temple, as well as the Jerusalem was invaded from 605 BC first, and then after that 597 BC, and followed by by the total destruction in 586 BC. So the three invasion, because God was disciplining them. So in today's context, if we sin against God, we will be desolate. That means the temple will be destroyed, and even the city was destroyed. So that means that we curse us if we do not observe the command of God. Or that. So incidentally, after the prayer, and Daniel was still around, about 90 years old, and at a young age, about 17, he was already in exile, and then he stayed there for probably 70 years or more. And then when the people returned to their country, he was still there, still on a mission, serving the enemy territory, so-called. But you know something? The first thing when they returned, they went back, the first thing they built is not their city, it's not their house, it's the temple. Right? Because the city was built probably close to 100 years later, under Ezra
Nehemiah time, right?
But the temple was rebuilt on smaller, not much smaller than King Solomon temple, and it was very discouraging. Say the former global temple was greater than the current one that he rebuilt, and it's much smaller. But then through that, in the Malachi, he read the word Malachi, and God was speaking to them, say, you know, although this one is small, but then you can see that the future glorious temple, that is the church, okay, that will be the eternal and the glorious temple. That is even greater than Solomon temple. Alright, but at least there was a reinstitution of the temple worship. And of course, one category of people who are minor prophet, minor prophets. Alright, and Haggai here, Haggai. Prophet is they're still building their houses, okay, instead of their temple. They are focusing on their house instead of building the temple when they return to Jerusalem. So you see the important thing and the significant thing that when you put God, if they build God's temple first, and God will bless them later on to build the city, alright, and build their homes, and also reinstate them into the worship. So one significant thing we can learn from here that the destruction of the temple and the city is because of their sin. And may God give them a chance to do that. They have Daniel is one of the few that is prayerful and pray for the return. And then when they first return, okay, the first thing is to build the temple. So same thing, when the first thing you put God first, temple first, sculptures first, God will bless the city, God will bless the home, God will bless the job. Oh, bless me. And this is the covenant of love. So today the emphasis is living a life of love is a covenant of love. God has called us to be engaged in a covenant of love. And this love, okay, this covenant of love is with those who love it. And how many people love Jesus? There are not many. Alright? Only a few who enter the narrow gate. So this covenant of love is only a few who enter. Okay, let's look at the verse 3. So I turn to the Lord and please with him in prayer and petition, in fasting and in sackcloth and ashes. And I pray to the Lord, the God, and confess, Lord, the great and awesome God, and keep his covenant of love with those who love him and keep his covenant. I think it's a powerful verse. It says that God is an awesome God, great and awesome, and will keep his covenant of love. What is this covenant of love? With those who love him. But how many people love him? There are not many. And those who love him will keep his commandments. And so these are the minority. And it is God's enablements that we can love him, we can continue with him. But in this time of pandemic and this COVID, but many they are very comfortable online. Alright, they are not available to go outside even though it's open up, right? So they too comfortable really. Sometimes they don't spend their time, they don't go online. Okay? And how many people actually go through the whole online? Alright, maybe they just see the first 5 minutes, maybe the last 5 minutes. Maybe they won't see. Alright, they don't watch. Alright. How many really sit through the whole sermon, right? So it takes a lot of discipline, you know, all that. So the worst thing you like on being positive for us. So anyway, here keeping the covenant of love, I think that's the keeps us going. The covenant of love is that God can give us the promises. Okay? So if whatever in COVID or no COVID, we still come to church. Okay, we are not afraid because God is more powerful than the COVID. And because of the covenant of love, alright, because of the love. What's the covenant of love? I will spell up in Deuteronomy for you. And that's the things that keep us going. So we must constantly keep that covenant of love on fire for Jesus and saving souls, touching and putting God's kingdom first and not to be swallowed by this materialism. You know, I was reading last night about chapter 7, 25 about the Antichrist. You know, he can introduce materialism to this world, right? For you, like Satan will give the promise to give Jesus Christ all the glories of this world. So same thing, many, he will lure you, you'll be tempted by the materialism of this world, the the worldly lifestyle of this world. And then so much so that you didn't have time for God. You will not have time for God. And you're so caught up with the worldly stuff, and then and you have no time for God. But that's what Satan do. So we become very secular. Right? So secularism is not the materialism are this worldliness. I say the Bible says you will love the world, the love of the Father is not you. You love the world, the love of the Father is not you. Right? Only those who does the will of God will live forever. Right? So that is the covenant of love that we must his covenant of love is that we call us to the Antioch of the fires, and he called to you to spread the gospel to the entire world. And that is the mission. And that is the mission to us before he's coming back. You have to bring in the number, the exact number. And now we have to keep on going. Even our church came in this pandemic. Now, I believe the government will open up to 5, and then in the room you can stay 5%. We are now only allowed 2%. So we will go ahead with the can. Right? And then we're not afraid of the COVID, right? No need to be afraid. Just pray and do whatever that necessary and just go on. Don't be scared. Don't do anything really for God. Alright? So, but amazingly, this COVID, the more intense, the more people jump again. Amen? Praise God. Alright? So praise God. Alright? So, let's look at the covenant of love. God saying in Deuteronomy 31, you fully obey me and carefully follow all my commandments, and will set you high above all the nations. You become very powerful on earth. Okay, in your field, in your study, and in your job, and you'll be high above all the nations. All this blessing will come on you, and if you obey, you'll be blessed in the city, you'll be blessed in the country. The fruit of your womb will be blessed, the crop will be blessed, your animal will be blessed, and then you will persist, and you'll be blessed when you come in. And you're blessed when you go out. God will protect you from COVID-19 and your family. You just let it be right. Okay, you don't have to be afraid. Okay, just observe. Okay, like COVID, the disease is invisible. God also is invisible. His angels are there. His power is there. Alright? He allows. Alright? He allows and then he will protect you. Okay? And nothing happened without his permission. Okay? Nothing happened by chance. And the Lord will grant you that the enemy who rise up against you will be defeated. Satan will be defeated right in front of you. The demons will be defeated right in front of you. And they will come from all directions, but you're free from all. And the Lord will send a blessing on your bonds. And everything you put your hand to, everything you do, you'll be successful. And the Lord will bless you in the land he's giving you. And the Lord will establish you as a holy people. And his promise, if you keep his command and the Lord and walk in obedience, then all the people of the earth will see that you are called by the name of God, and they will fear you. The Lord will grant you abundant prosperity in the fruit of your womb, your animals, your crop, as his promise to your ancestors. Verse 12, and the Lord will open the heavens, the storehouse of his bounty, to send you rain in your land and to bless all the works of your hand. You will lend to many nations, but you will not borrow from none. And the Lord will make you the what? The head, the leader, not the tail. Okay? And you will always be at the top, never at the bottom. So these are the blessings, the covenant of love for us. You obey, you have the faith to believe. Because I believe that a Christian will shine in every aspect to show, to demonstrate the supremacy of Jesus Christ in every aspect of our life. But do not turn aside to any other commandments I give you today, to the right or to the left, without following other gods and serving them. So God wants us, there will be curses. You can read on now, you're not focusing on the curses. You can read on verse 15 down your own. Deuteronomy 31, when all these blessings and curses are set before you, and you take them to heart, whenever the Lord your God disperses you among the nation, when you and your children return to the Lord your God, you know they were dispersed, right? Daniel, because of the trade invasion, because of the sins of the forefathers, and they were dispersed to the nations, alright? And because of the sin, and these are the curses that follow. And when you
And your children return to the Lord and God and obey Him with all your heart and with all your soul according to everything He commands you today. Then the Lord God will restore your fortune. Have compassion on you, gather you again from all nations where He scattered you. Okay, yeah, people are scattered. They're no longer going to church. They're not a good sign. Because why? There's no empowerment of God to bring them back. You know why? Because they are rejecting God. Then they are scattered. You know, if you are coming to church regularly, that's a very good sign. Because that is the empowerment of God and the grace of God that enable you. Alright, and unless you walk out of His house, unless you choose your own way, alright, and as a result, you deprive yourself to be blessed by God. Alright, so, but there are not many, okay, not many observe the command of God, right, to observe the Sabbath, the principle, right? So if today you are able to serve, and you're able to come regularly, it's a blessing from God, it's God's grace. Don't reject the blessing, and don't be deceived by Satan, alright? And then you just move out, alright? And then go to the wrong direction, okay? But I tell you, Satan is active. He's always there to strike you for whether young Christian, mature Christian, or growing Christian, he will strike you at any time. I tell you, in my life as a Christian for more than since 1981, I observe, Satan works at all level. He's very cunning. Alright, you're not careful. I've seen people in our church, last time, we grew them very nicely, very powerfully. I share with you, and then all of a sudden, because of some attraction, they move out of the church, and then bring, you know, affected a few others. And you know, a group, about four of them, and I'll be able to talk to them, but the person didn't able to accept my explanation, because someone given a high position, alright, something, and then they was attracted to me. So, but, and then we grew them, so nicely, you know, and then not careful with them, well, I think, you know, so what I'm trying to say is, initially, you know, because I tell you, the world is being this way, they give you a position, then you will stay with them. They give you money, you stay with them. Okay, you buy you over. Alright, so be careful. Okay, don't be tempted by the high position. They give you a leadership position, they give you a highest position, then you go. Okay, but actually, don't cover position, because why? You may be promoted to, you may be given a position of high position, but you are so called promoted to the level of inefficiency. And when you cannot do the job, you suffer. Okay, you'll be under a lot of attacks. Because if you are, say, if you are weak, Satan will come in. Especially in the spiritual ministry. If you are weak, Satan will come in, will attack, and bring you down all the way to ground zero. Alright? So you have to be, because my see, you have to go to the high position, you might have the maturity. You must have that spiritual power to be able to see through Satan's scheme and overcome Satan. So leadership position, the Bible says, you strike the shepherd and the sheep will scatter. Alright. So if you want to be in the positions of leadership and power, you need to be a high level of maturity because you are fighting in spiritual warfare. Alright. So don't be deceived by Satan. Alright, Satan is all around. Maybe at this point, you know, there are many things I can share, but not at this point, be a personal level of experience. I tell you, you need a lot of discernment, okay? Alright, sometimes Satan can work even in Christian organization. Alright, it's all there. I tell you, there are many pastors satisfied with any experience. They also experience. So we can tell you is that you have to watch out, alright? So, and then don't be deceived by Satan. Okay, let's move on. And even if you have been banished from the distant land under the heavens, from there the Lord your God will gather you and bring you back. He will bring you to the land that belongs to your ancestors. You will be taken possession. He will make you more prosperous and numerous than before. You know, so God is good. Although they scattered, they sinned against God, and the little end was better. Okay, God bless him. The king Nebuchadnezzar. Alright, he was so proud and he went back 7 years. And his later part was greater. So God is a gracious God. He's a God of economy. Don't let nothing go to waste. So God will restore. Hey, look at what Nebuchadnezzar experienced. All the same time, my sanity will restore after 7 years. My honor and splendor will return to me for the glory of my kingdom. My advisor and overseer sought me out, and I was restored to my throne and became
even greater than before. See, that's a gracious God. Huh? But don't move away from God. Okay, when you are being a blessed, already blessed poppy, don't go and move out of it. Otherwise, you get yourself into trouble. Be your own grave. Alright? So a lot of people, they like to do, for whatever reason, they see, they dig their own grave. They move out of their blessing. A lot of it, blessing very good, and they move out of it, they become the curse. Alright? And then dig their own grave. Alright? So you have to be very careful in every aspect, every decision that you make. Alright, so now we are able to enjoy what you enjoy, it's a blessing from God, so treasure it, alright, and grow the blessing. And the Lord your God will circumcise your heart and the hearts of your descendants, so that you may love Him with all your heart and with all your soul and all your life. The Lord will put all these curses on your enemy and hate and persecute, and you will again obey the Lord and follow all His command I will give you today. Then the Lord will make you most prosperous. Okay? Hey, God desires to give us the best. Okay, don't go for second best. Alright? Don't choose third best, second best, or fourth best. Choose the best. One and only best. Right? Because He wants to make you most prosperous. So our God is a generous God. He desires to bless you richly. Alright? So, and enjoy the blessing. And treasure the blessing. And use the blessing to invest in His kingdom. And make you prosper in all the work of your hand, and in the fruit of your womb, and the young of your livestock, and the crops of your land. Verse 10. If you obey the Lord and keep His commandment, and decree that are written, and turn to the Lord your God with all your heart and with all your soul. And verse 6. And verse 5. And Daniel said, Lord, we have sinned and done wrong. We have been wicked and rebel, and we are turned away from your commands and law. We are not listened to your servants, the prophet. I like this verse. See, and to your servants, the prophets who spoke in your name to our kings, our princes, our ancestors, and all people of the earth. So you can see, the prophet is above the king. You see that? And God spoke, that means God commanded you to the prophet. Then to the kings, right? So it's about the king. In the book of Ezekiel, 40 to 45, the priest, the men of the so-called the leaders of God are greater than the kings and the princes. Because even the kingdom reversal, you know that this world is an evil world. It's an evil world, and then Satan is behind the scene, alright? And all this he led you to materialism and all kind of worldly temptation, alright? And then they rule. The world, the Satan is ruling so called, right? Behind the scene. Huh? But then, of course, God is in charge. And then the thing is, the kingdom reverses. Huh? Because the system of the world is evil. Alright? Why do you mean by evil? Because, there's a lot of cheap abusers, oppressions. Oppressive system, right? And even evil structure and all that. Right? So, and then but the kingdom reverses. We are children of God, we reign with the power of God. Not by our own power, but we the power. The kingdom reverses, you'll be kings, queens, and princess, and so on. So here the prophet is above the kings, above the prince, right? Because God spoke to the prophet, to the king, not to the king, to the prophet. You see that? So that means we are men, women of God, our positions will be high. In the kingdom of God, the kingdom reversal. And that is the blessed hope. And that's what God will empower us, and we will wait in Him forever and ever. And that's why, so on earth, God has our hearts. See whether we will be in it, so see whether we will invest in the kingdom of God. So just now, Han, we have one question. He asked me a question. He said, Mami, pay tithe. You see, it's a benchmark. Okay, and invest. I say not everybody pay their tithes. Okay, and only in fact not many. Alright, but we all should work towards that, because why? The one belongs to God. And it's a benchmark. And it's God's grace. I told him, don't just give 10%, give 90%. That may the Lord bless you, Han. And one day they gave as much beyond 10%, even 90%. Alright? Blessed.
Okay, you earn 1 million, right? You give 900,000, you still got 100,000, more than enough to spend, right? Right? So, let's God bless you, huh? Alright, so don't be afraid to bless the kingdom of God. You don't know why, whatever you invest, God remembers. You get multiple folds in the eternal kingdom. The one, cannot compare with this world. The whole world put together cannot even buy the least a reward in the heaven. Cannot. Alright, so that is, you must have a faith to believe God is powerful. So, must dare to invest in the kingdom of God. Okay, and don't be afraid. Okay, you must be bold because you will be richly blessed. Okay, don't be afraid. Even though you have nothing, to call you, but you can just survive with basic things. That's okay, because all your money, all your investment go to the kingdom of God. Bless the soul, bless. Okay, you will have a powerful ministry and you will grow tremendously. Okay, you have the faith to believe that. Okay, let's move on. Okay, let's move on to. Lord, you are righteous, but this day we are covered with shame. The people of Judah and the inhabitants of Jerusalem and all Israel, both near and far, they're talking about the Jewish people, right? In all the countries where we have scattered us because of our unfaithfulness. You see, people are scattered, they're not longer just because they're unfaithfulness to God. Okay, basically is that unfaithfulness. You can see the pattern, right? Because they are unfaithful, they are scattered, and then they are being deprived of worship. Because they sin against God, they can worship either the temple was raised to zero. They cannot worship anymore in the temple. Correct? Right? So same thing, if you are unfaithful, you'll be scattered. So you must be faithful. How you be faithful? You must decide to put God first. You must decide to put God first. You know, over these years we have raised some youth, right? In fact, ever since we have a camp that you come very regularly, seven of them, right? Every camp they join us. And now they are very regular. Alright, so I think they become very full, zealous, and enthusiastic, so they get more involved. Okay, it's good to get involved. Okay, to put God first and able to balance up with your work, with your family life, and you'll be richly blessed. So the key is discipline and balance. Alright, be faithful to God and want to raise a powerful Christian. Okay, the Bible says we are called to be martyr. You know, the Acts 1:8, right? How to be martyr, a martyrdom, to lay down our life for Jesus Christ and spread the gospel to the entire world. Acts 1:8, right? So this is our calling. We don't be a compromised Christian. We go to church and become a tradition, right? It become a culture. No, it's a relationship. You must really do something for God. You must change the world. Must God empower you to change the world, to save life, to save soul, and do it with wisdom and with love. Alright? And do it the best way. Alright? So it is very important that we are here to turn the world upside down. Okay, we're here to change the world. We must be active and proactive. We cannot be inactive. And we must initiate. We must be strong and dynamic and powerful, and don't be afraid, okay? And let nothing hinder you from doing God's work, okay? Take charge and be in charge of your situation, and alright? So we are here to transform the world, alright? Transfer the world for a better place for everybody to live in. Okay, let's move on. And he went on to say,
Jesus said, no one can come to me unless the Father has enabled me. So you can see that. Okay, you cannot come today here unless God enabled you. God made it possible for you. And also, you choose to come and respond to this, to your initiative. We and our kings, okay, but then they'll continue. We and our kings and our ancestors are covered with shame. Oh Lord, because we sinned against you. The Lord our God is merciful and forgiving, even though we have rebelled against you. So this is the Daniel prayer. And we have not obeyed the Lord our God and kept the law he gave us through his servant the prophets. And all Israel has transgressed, sinned against the Lord, and turned away, refusing to obey you. Therefore the curses and swan judgment written in the law of Moses, the servant of God, have been poured out on us because we have sinned against him. That's why they are in captivity. So when you sin, you are in bondage, you are in captivity, and you are addicted, you are bound. Okay, you know, technology like phone, I can bind zimmer. Okay, until so much that you cannot let go. Okay, that one need to be set free. Alright? And apart from other addiction, sexual addiction or whatever, alright, go ahead and set you free. And the best thing is busy for God, so that all these things will not tempt you. Alright, so you are able to use the power of God will be free from this. You have fulfilled the word spoken against us and against our ruler by bringing us great disaster. You can see that sins bring great disaster. Alright, I see that this COVID-19, God allows it, okay, and it's a part of the discipline, and it's also part of the punishment. Alright, and but we are righteous. Okay, I think we don't need to fear all this, okay, and God can protect us. Alright, He can save the Noah, the family of eight, right, from the flood. And destroy the world and save you. You can be the eight of them. Only very few, right? Out of the whole world here. Super few, right? So how many few, right? How many got one? Praise God. Yeah. Alright. So that God can protect you so you not to be drowned. Under the whole heaven, nothing has ever done like this. What has been done to Jerusalem? Just as it's written in the law of Moses, and all the disaster has come to us. Yet we are not sought the favor of the Lord, our God, by turning from our sins and give attention to the truth, to His word. And the most important thing in the preaching, as I said already, is not an organization. All these are secondary. Okay, these are good, not bad things. But the most important thing is the truth. The truth will set us free. Okay, from our sins and bondages. Alright, so the truth is most important. And the renewed and the insight. The Lord did not hesitate to bring the disaster on us. For the Lord our God is a righteous God in everything He done, yet we have not obeyed Him. Now, Lord our God, who brought us people out of Egypt with a mighty hand and made for Himself a name that endured to this day. We have sinned and we have done wrong. Lord, in keeping with all your righteous act, turn away your anger and your wrath from Jerusalem. So you pray for the Jewish people, right? And your city and your holy hill. Our sins and the iniquities of our forefathers have made Jerusalem and your people an object of scorn and all those around us. Because it was invasions by the Babylonians, all ground zero, the temple as well as the city. And now, our God, hear the prayer and petitions of the servant. For your sake, Lord, look with favor on your desolate sanctuary. Does that mean? That means empty, right? Empty, deserted. Right? Because why? Of the sin. They're not allowed to worship anymore. Give ear, our God, and here open your eyes and see the desolation of the city. Right? You don't put God first, your city will be wiped out. You don't put God first, your house will be wiped out. And bear your name. We do not make requests of you because we are righteous. We make requests because of your great mercy. So everything, always think of God's grace and mercy. Sometimes things get done not because of our power, but because of God's grace and God's enablement. And oftentimes we do wrong things, yet still God help us. God is gracious. So when you sin, I don't feel bad. I don't say, I condemn myself. No. Say, God, I won't do it again. And give me another chance. Then you do for. Just like that, just move on. Okay, don't worry about the past. Don't let the devil go and haunt you about your sin and your past. Don't feel so guilty, you know, until you cannot sleep. You know, you feel so sad, you feel so dumb. We all make mistakes. Okay? And if you God forgive you, you don't forgive yourself, no one can forgive you, right? But you condemn yourself, then you know it's your choice, right? So don't condemn yourself. We are all precious in the sight of God. We made in the image of God. We are beautiful in the sight of God. Alright? So just move on, leave behind the past and move on for God. Get on fire for God. Okay? Leave your past with you. Lord, listen, forgive. Lord, listen, Lord, forgive. Lord, hear and act. Interesting, huh? For your sake, my God, do not delay. before your city and the people bear your name. While I was speaking and praying, confessing my sin and the sins of my people and Israel, making my request to the Lord my God for his holy hill. While I was still in prayer, that's where the breakthrough here, Gabriel coming, angel Gabriel. The man I seen in the earlier visions came to me in sweet flight about the time of the evening sacrifice. He instructed me and said, Daniel, I now come to give you insight and understand the revelation. As soon as you began to pray, a word went up and which I have come to tell you. So the order was given by God and Gabriel came to him, for you are a man highly esteemed and respected by God. So he's a man that God honored. Therefore, consider the word and understand the vision. 77 means 70 times 7. Alright? And this 70 times 7, they'll break into 7-7. Okay, that is 49 years, according to scholar. Of course, some say 7 years. 7 times 7, more fitting for the content. 7-7. It takes 49 years to rebuild Jerusalem, alright? 49 years to plus, yeah. I say 49 years to rebuild Jerusalem. And the 7-7. And then the 62-7 is 62-7 is 134 years. That one is from the time after the restoration of Jerusalem to the time of Jesus Christ baptism. Is 434 years plus 49 years is 483 years, that's 69.7. 69.7 is 483. Alright? So it's in the 70 week, but in between the 69 week and the 70 week, there is a prophetic gap. The prophetic gap is from the time they rejected Jesus Christ and crucified on the cross, and then followed by the invasions of the Titus, the Roman Emperor, AD 70, destroying the Jerusalem, the people were scattered. Again, the history repeats itself because they reject Jesus Christ, the temple was tear down, was torn down, and then it was scattered. Alright? So until 1948, okay, then it's a span of almost 2,000 years. And then from the indefinite period of 69 week to the 70 week, there's a prophetic gap. There's a gap of how many years? Almost 2,000 years. Until 1948, but today is 2021. 2021, the 70 week, we don't know exactly the indefinite gap for the 69 week to the 70 week. The 70 week is the 7 years of the great, 7 years of the great tribulation. Okay? And now we are moving towards that era of 7 years. Alright, okay, there's one suggestion. There's one verse in the Bible in Matthew, I think it's 34, 35. It says, this generation will not pass away. Okay, some people suggested that this generation is 1948, independence. From there you come 70 to 80 years. If it's 70 years, it's 2018. He said, this nature will not pass. He said, heaven and earth will pass, but will not pass, Jesus said in verse 35. And 2018 plus 70 is 2018. In the book of Psalm, it says, chapter 90, verse 10, it says, man lived to 80 years old. If it's 80 years old, 1948 plus 80 is 2028. It says, this generation will not pass 2028. If this interpretation is correct, so the Christ will come before 2028. If this is correct, but we do not know 100%. Okay, but this is one view. Okay, but I tell you, but the point I'm trying to say is that this COVID-19 and a more variant coming in Germany, it points to the fact that they are drawing closer to the coming of the Lord. So he hasn't come back. The one reason he hasn't come because the souls haven't come in. Okay, as many souls haven't come in. So we have to bring in the numbers. Alright, then the soul come, then he will come back and bring in the 7 years. Alright? And during the 7 years, Antichrist will initiate the 7 years of the covenant. So they will give some economic benefits to Israel. Alright, but halfway, he break the covenant. So he will sit inside the temple and declare himself as God. And then where the great tribulation set in. And that's where he bring in the third world war.
And that's when Jesus Christ comes back. And then you believe in the rapture, you come back with him and defeat the world. Alright? So we have not many years to do the work of God. Okay? In this COVID, I say this is an indefinite period we are now, before the last 7 years. Okay? So we are in this era, the end part of this indefinite gap. Alright? So this is the prophetic in the book of Daniel. Let's read on. 77, a decree for your people and your holy city to finish transgression, to put an end to sin. 77, to atone for wickedness during this, and to bring the everlasting righteousness. That's the 1,000-year millennium. To bring in the everlasting reign. So Daniel, he prayed, he had these revelations from God. And to seal up the vision and prophecy and to anoint the most holy place. And what is this holy, holy place? There's some suggestion that it is the Millennium Temple in the book of Ezekiel. Right, the Millennium Temple. And know and understand, from the time the word goes up to restore and rebuild Jerusalem until the anointed one. Okay, 49 years to rebuild Jerusalem. And during the, and the ruler comes and there will be seven sevens, 62 sevens. The first part is rebuilding Jerusalem, 62 as I mentioned already. And then onwards in 409 BC onward to 86. This is just an estimate. Okay? And Jesus water baptism, and altogether is 483 years and 456. And when it begins, the first seven is starting from the year 458 BC. This is according to some view. And so I already mentioned to you there's a gap there. And verse 26, the cut off here is Christ's crucifixion, okay? And the rejection of Christ after the 69 week, and Jerusalem was destroyed, and the Jewish people were scattered throughout the earth. Alright? So, okay, so you can see the destruction. Okay.
Now, truly, I tell you, this generation will certainly not pass until all these things will happen, right? Heaven and earth will pass away, but my words will never pass. All our days have come to 70 years or 80 if our strength endures. Okay? Now, verse 26. After the 62 weeks, 62 sevens, the anointed one will be put to death, Jesus Christ, and will have nothing. And the people of ruler will come in, the titles will come in to destroy the city and the sanctuary. And that's where Romans title keeps in. And then history will repeat itself, right? In the end time. And then the end will come very fast, and war will continue until the end. Desolation has been decreed. Alright? Let's move on. And he will confirm, Antichrist will confirm a covenant with many for 177 years. And in the middle of the 7 year, 3.5 years, he will put an end to the sacrifice offering. I mean, he becomes the God. In a temple, he will set up abomination that causes resolution. And until the end is far for him. So you can see this. Let's look at the chart, the end time. Okay, this one is the timeline of the end time. The church age. Now the gap is the present church age. Then you believe the rapture. Rapture will take place. That is before the ushering of the 7 years. Right, the last seven, the 70 weeks. And then you have the beginning of sorrow for 3.5 years. And then in the Great Tribulation for 3.5 years. And then in the middle there's a desecration of the temple. Alright? So you have tribulation. And then after the Great World War, the return of Jesus Christ at the end part. And then you're ushering the defeat of Satan. And so on. And then you're ushering the 1,000-year reign of the millennium peace. Alright? And Satan will then lose again before they have the new heaven and new eternal stage. Okay, so this is a timeline of the end times. Let's have another look. Okay, Daniel 17 week. You had 49 years, 7 weeks. Alright?
the restoration of the rebuilding of Jerusalem. Then you have 6,432 years. Okay, and this one is from after the restoration of Jerusalem to the time of Jesus Christ. And then after that, you have the prophetic gap of the indefinite period from after the rejection of Jesus Christ, the death of Jesus Christ, until now today. We are actually at this prophetic gap. Alright? And then once the Jesus Christ comes back, you believe the rapture that comes in, you'll usher in, come up here and John 4:1 and you believe that. And you will have a 1 year, 7 years, 3.5 years. And then, okay, so this is the timeline for Daniel, 70 weeks. So it's quite clear, right? It's quite clear about the revelations that Daniel gave. So what does it mean for us? Okay, this part I read to you, you have Bible, because I didn't type in this one. Okay, I want to type in. Let's look at Matthew. That's what we must do, live a life of love. Okay, just read to you, finishing area. Okay, the Bible says in Matthew 7:13, enter through the narrow gate, for wide is the gate and broad is the road that leads to destruction, and many enter through. But small is the gate and narrow is the road that leads to life. Only a few. Alright? Only a few who make a covenant. So there are not many strong ones. So maybe we just feel strong and powerful now. And the remaining years that we have, there are not many. Let's go all out for Jesus. Okay. Don't be affected by this. I say already. Most important thing is the word, the teaching of the word of God. And not only that, when you understand, go and do it and bring in souls. The church is not about building. Okay. It's not about any other thing. Most important thing is the word. And go out there and see. So you know, I like to start church from zero. You know, I used to talk to a bigger church. I have a bigger church in Singapore. I want to start church from zero. And this is the third church. And I really enjoy it because you experience God in a very powerful way. Church planting is the best mandate under heaven. Where you need a lot of faith. It doesn't mean that you need the power. You know, it's easy. Start from nothing. Can you imagine? You start from zero, you got nothing, nobody at all. And then you build the church. And then you see how God bless the church. And that's the best. That's why I say the best is local church. Start a local church. Mission, local church, not our church. Right? But the one you share separately, because the one not to be shared is because we talked to over the years, and also with other pastors and myself I study. Right? You're not as better. It's the local church. Invest in the local church and grow in the local church and grow and touch life and touch life. Start from leading a cell group and then from there you grow and watch out, move up and do discipline in your study. You must study the Bible a lot. Don't spend your time here and there, keep you busy. Invest the work, quality time. Spend time reading the word, understand the word, read through the whole Bible and very good opportunity to present well, and know how to organize well. Don't just say a few verses wrong. Just go in depth. Okay, focus in the depth of the Bible. Don't say a few verses here and there, and feel good about it. No, it's not like that. You must really prepare well, and teach well, and bring with an impact. Alright? And then you can impact lives and touch lives, so then you can be effective. Alright, you must be effective in building souls and nurturing others, because it's spiritual warfare. You need to keep the best time, okay? And treasure the opportunity, right? So, and then the Bible says, only watch out for false prophet. Come in sheep's clothing, and they are ferocious wolf. You can see their fruit. By their fruit, you know them. So, example is the best master. Every good tree bear good fruits. This morning I was telling the Chinese congregation, by instantly I tell you, God takes you as you are. Although we are imperfect this moment, God can still use you to save so. No matter however imperfect you are, maybe you're just starting, right? To learn how to share. It's okay, just do your best. God can still use you to touch life and save so. You have to be perfect. You cannot be perfect at that. It's nobody is perfect. Okay? Whatever position, whatever level you are, just perform and do it in faith and let God use you to do so. Okay? In spite of your many imperfections. Okay? Because it's not save some of your power, it's God's power. Okay, you're just a vessel. However simple it may be, let God use. But then, when you're the vessels, make full use of the opportunity and do your best. And then you will improve over time, grow over time, until the day Jesus Christ comes back. But still, you know, perfectly perfect in heaven. Alright? So the fruit, okay? So the fruit is very important. You can see this morning I told the thorn bushes, you cannot find grape in the thorn bushes. Or you can find, so yesterday I said, you cannot find a fixer in a thistle, okay, where you will be poked, you will be hurt. Alright, and this, so among the wolves, you get hurt, alright? Okay, they may appear gentle, but you work with them, they actually wolf. Okay, you don't know them, you may appear to be gentle, but when you work with them, they actually wolf, to kill you, to injure you, to oppress you, and even to kill you, alright? So it's a real world, so don't be just deceived by appearance, but when you go that deep, you will discover, So, a bad tree will not bear bad good fruit. Only a good tree will bear good fruit. Alright? So is their life. Okay? You cannot facade for a long one. After a while, you can show the color, the true color. Alright? And, okay, and, so most important thing is not that you cast out demons or heal many people. No? Most important thing is, are you doing for God or doing for yourself? Most important is your life. So be a wise builder. The Bible says that you wise builder will hear God's word and put into practice. Okay, Jesus Christ practice, then you teach. Alright, and practice so that he is a model first. Okay, it's so it's power. Of course, Jesus can do that, but you know, for us, we have to go, you know, practice, teach. But before we are being and doing, and then transformation and so on. So it's very importantly that you live a life of love. Alright. Be a great blessing, sacrificial blessing, and never mind about what other thing. According to your faith, according to the blessings of God. So today's topic is live a life of love. As you know, that our blessed hope is that when Jesus Christ comes back, we will live in Him forever and ever in glory. Let us be on fire for God with the baptism of the Holy Spirit. All right, and of say fire. Fire means you're on fire for God. And then the fire will purify us. The trial will purify us, will cleanse us. Right? So we need the power of God. Come to church camp where you'll be empowered. Okay? And we will pray in spiritual gifts, healing, prayer, and so on, etc. Let the power of God sanctify you. Alright? The word sanctify you. Amen? Okay, today, basically, you are here, you say, God, I want to live a life of love. I want to be a model. I have a blessed hope. Because of your soon coming, I want to invest my time as a good steward and give my best for you. And do everything, the best effort for you. And use the mind you have given me, not only the heart, but also the talent given. And put into your kingdom and bless the people. And power them. Today, he says, Lord, I'm willing. I pray for you. Anyone? Yes. Any others? Okay, praise God. Okay, let's pray. Lord, we thank you for all of them who raised their hand and those, all of everyone, especially those who raised their hand and not their head. Lord, may you use them as a channel of love and minister powerfully to the glory of Jesus Christ and for great benefits. In Jesus' name, bless all of them. Praise God. Thank you, Jesus. Okay, let's.